for guys. FOB special. Basically like one of my specialties here in London is making chocolate Afghan cookies. Yep. In demand, but yeah. I love making them, but I especially like eating them as well. So I've actually missed a few steps, but at the moment I'm making a batch here for Saturday. There's a Kongai on, which is a feast for the London family here. And basically the stage that I'm up to is you take butter and some sugar and you cream it up. The stage I'm at the moment is I'm basically combining it with the plain flour that I've got here. That a plain flour, I've sifted in the flour in there. I'm basically mixing it up before I put in the cocoa. So yeah, we'll come back to when we're at the later stage, just starting the new stage of combining the cocoa in. Okay, just having a bit of a problem because it's actually a bigger batch than I usually do. So we've got the cocoa going in there, we've got the plain flour with the sugar and also the butter. So we're just combining that all, and pretty soon we'll be putting in the cornflakes. Okay, we've combined the cocoa, and this is basically what it looks like with the cocoa in there now. So it's all combined really nicely, and now is the best part. We've got cornflakes. Yes, you're probably wondering, cornflakes and cookies? Well, unless you've tried an Afghan cookie, this is a central ingredient. So I like to use my hands here, or actually I've been using my hands. I'm going to dump it all in. Now remember, this is about 2.5 times the batch that I usually do. So get your hands in there if you can. Start punching it up. You probably can't hear me, but... And what we want to try and create is we want to get it all mixed in there and leave nothing behind, so it just looks like one brown muck. Well, there you have it. Basically, that's got some of the you can see some of the cornflakes in there. And pretty much we're at the stage now. That noise in the background, you can hear, is the oven that's on now. We got it at 180 degrees, which I think is about number 4 in the gas oven. Out. What I'm going to do is I'm going to start making the cookies. So pretty much you get a handful about that shape and roll it up into a ball. Usually I grease the trays, but I've put on some grease proof paper or baking paper on there. Pretty much I'll just put the ball on, and what I like to do now is just get a normal fork. Be a fancy one, I think, and just press it down. So that's it. And what will happen during the baking process is that it would actually expand a bit more, maybe just a bit more in size, and yeah, just to about the size of a normal cookie. So yeah, but I'm gonna put it into the oven for about 10 to 12 minutes, or until it's settled, and then you bring it out of the oven. I wish you had smell-o vision, because it really smells nice when it's baking. So we'll come back when the first batch comes up. 10-12 minutes have passed, so we're going to go and see if the cookies have been done. Smells beautiful, and I've risen just a little bit. So here's one. Yep, it looks like a bit of crack, but they should have been in there enough to allow them to set. And what basically happens and keeps them together is the butter and the sugar. Now that they've melted, they've combined, it keeps the cookie in shape. So that is a chocolate Afghan cookie. Now I'm gonna put some melted chocolate on top as a nice one. You can put a walnut, as they do in like New Zealand, but I don't put them on, because the chocolate on the chocolate is enough. But there you go, folks, that is a chocolate Afghan. We'll show you the results later, and we'll also show you the recipe again. Chocolate Afghans a la Ivan Stiles. You've been watching FOB TV, and that's me. It's a wrap. I'm going to have one.
So there you go. I've done a few just with the spatula. Apply, generously apply melted dark chocolate atop the lovely chocolate Afghan cookies. Do they look good?
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I've just done the cookies. And the best part when you finish. Yeah, go on. Okay. So, I've iced most of the cookies. I need to do a few more, so I need to actually melt some more chocolate. In the meantime, yum.